basically what I've done with the Fiesta, from what I've seen, is you can disable the shift indicator. You cannot disable the double honk because we do not have the, I'll call it the module or the software bits to be able to disable it like the F-150 and the other vehicles have. We don't have that. Also can't do powerful mirrors. We also cannot do the global windows up and down because we don't have the right hardware for it in these cars. European cars have it, we don't. However, you can change the sync themes. So this is the Ford GT theme. You cannot use an ST splash screen. So if you like an ST splash screen, you have to use the generic Ford theme that came with the car. However, what I have done is I've added this right here. It says 69 degrees. That is your climate temperature setting. I've added it to where it'll display the temperature as you're changing it. And for the most part, that is done by just simply adding your climate button, which our Fiestas don't come with from the factory. If you look at the F-150 manuals spreadsheets that are out there, when you're trying to enable the climate zone menu, you will have to tell it that you have dual. If you tell it you have single climate control, it will not pop up. So even though you don't have a dual zone climate control, that's what it takes to do it, but it all still works. You got your defrost, max, you know, regular, AC the same. You can do it all through here. Honestly, it's kind of worthless. I can go right here and push every button I want to, but it is very cool. Here is one cool function I like though. Driving down the road, just one hand on the wheel. Set temperature to 75.
75, is that right?
Yes. So it does change it to 75. So with being Sync 3, you cannot add navigation because they have different hard drive sizes, and hell, even updating these through USB is hard enough just to do like a Sync 3 version 3.0 update on some cards because the space for memory is limited. Unlike Sync 2 versions, you can actually just basically get a nav card and enable navigation. I have told it to turn on navigation. It will add the menu or the nav button in there, and as soon as you push it, it faults out. But that's because, once again, the hardware is not there. I'm trying to think of anything else I've added on here. I can't really think of anything else here. I have disabled my TPMS. For winter wheels, I actually ordered TPMS Ford factory that came with my car, same part numbers. For some reason, we can't get them to activate. We're assuming the TPMS are bad. We've got the Ford tool to do it. It goes around, you go around the car on the screen, it shows do left front, right front, do the whole process. It says we are good, and then it will flash TPMS tires are low. So I just disabled it, and I'll probably keep it disabled even though I've got my summer wheels back on. That's a pretty good overview. I'm trying to think of anything else. I know the shift light, some people like it, some don't. I may disable it. I don't know. There's not a lot you can do in relation to what you can do on some of like the trucks and the Fusions. For example, Bambi mode. They're the module for that to where you can run your fogs along with your low beams and high beams. You can't do it with this car. That module is not there. It's not in the menu settings for you to be able to do it. However, you could rig up a relay system and make that work. I will probably do that as I am getting headlight retrofits. It's a mini D2S 4.0 setup from Morimoto. So I will probably do it at that point, but as far as from a software standpoint, with Forscan, no, you cannot enable Bambi mode and fog lights plus high beams. Other than that, if you guys have any questions, you can get a hold of me. But basically the best thing you can do for yourself is just look under the APIM screens, the F-150 spreadsheets. I'm willing to give you that link. I'll put it in this YouTube description. That's the best way to learn and try some different stuff. Now, if you have a question of whether or not you can do something, feel free to ask me that too. I don't want to sit here and give you a tutorial on how to do everything. I'm not going to sit here and teach you what buttons to push necessarily. But if you have a question as to whether something will work, I will probably let you know. I've pretty well fiddled with just about everything you can do. There may even be some options I didn't tell you right now because maybe there are options I just didn't feel like I wanted to use. So, but like I said, just ask me just about anything. Just don't expect me to tell you how to use Forscan, and everything will be all right.